This video is brought to you by Crumble, the powerful yet easy to use CRM. Want to get more out of Google Contacts? Well, in this video, I'm sharing with you 7 tips and tricks so you can work faster, smarter, and get the most out of Google Contacts. Tip number 1, let's use labels to make email so much easier. Now, labels here within Google Contacts is a great way to organize all of your contacts information. For example, I've got a label called follow-up, so I can quickly see the individuals I need to follow up with, and I've got another one called new leads. But these labels are so much more than just organizing our contacts or putting contacts into different groups. For example, I have one here called client team, but this really becomes powerful when I combine it with my email. Here within my Gmail account, when I go to select who I'm going to send this message to, all I have to do is start to type in the name of that label. And here it is, client team, and it shows me it has 6 members. By selecting this, all 6 members of my team are added to my email, and now I can continue to write this particular message. Tip number 2, making our labels stand out. Now, you can add as many labels as you want, but as you can see here, it's hard to distinguish between our different labels. Google Contacts doesn't give us the ability to add a color like we can within Gmail. And if we look at our list here on the right-hand side, it's very difficult for me to see how many different labels are actually displayed here, and even reading between the different ones can be often confusing. Well, there is a workaround that we can use that will make things stand out so much better. So for example, maybe I want my new leads label to stand out, not only on my list here on the right-hand side, but maybe also here in my list of labels on the left side menu. What I'm going to do is select rename label, and I'm going to put my cursor at the very end of the label. Now on a Windows keyboard, if you select the Windows key plus the period key, that will bring up the emoji dialog. And if you're a Mac user, you can select Control plus Command plus Spacebar. And in this case, I'm going to select this red circle here, and I'm going to hit save. Now we have a very distinctive color and shape at the back of this label. It will not only appear in the list, but it will appear here on the left-hand side as well. So it's very easy for me to see these new leads. Now you can either do this for just some of your key labels, or you can do it for all of your labels if you like. Here within my client team, let's do this again. And perhaps I'm going to select this laptop or keyboard and hit save. And once again, it makes it that much more distinct. Now, the reason why I recommend adding your emojis to the end of your label is because if you add them at the front, it will reorder your labels based on the actual name of that emoji. So for example, if this emoji is named laptop, it's going to treat this label as an L, and that would be sorted now down further below. So put your emojis at the very end and make your labels stand out even more. Number 3, let's customize the display order of our contacts. Here in the top right-hand corner, you will see these little 3 dots, which will reveal our list settings. We have 2 options available to us. Number 1 is display density. By default, it'll be set as comfortable, but if you'd like to see more contacts at a time, you can select compact. It essentially will remove the little picture profile icon and make things that much closer together. But if you don't like that, we can always come back to display density and come back to our comfortable view. The second option here has to do with changing the column order. If I select this option here, you can see the 5 different choices we have available to us. So for example, maybe I want my labels to come before the email address. I can drag and reorder these columns any way that I like. And instead of the job title and company, maybe I would like the phone number displayed instead. All I need to do is select done, and now both my order and what is displayed is changed based on my preferences. Sticking with customizing our view, remember that you can also view your names in either first name or last name order. To do that, we want to move up to the gear icon and select More Settings. Within this dialog, we can change the phone number country code, but also choose how we want our name sorted, either by first name or by last name. Tip number four, delegating access to someone else. Now, if you use Google Contacts within your work, school, or other group environment, you can delegate access to someone else within your domain. This is very helpful if you work with a virtual assistant or someone else who would like to have access to your contact list. In this case, what we need to do is select the gear icon and then select Delegate Access. And here you'll have the opportunity to invite one or more people to have access to your contacts so that they can view, edit, delete, and also create contacts. Now, the next tip in our list is one of my all-time favorites and probably the one that I use most frequently. More often than not, I want to access my Google Contacts while I'm dealing with my email here within Gmail. Now, it's true, I could come over here to the sidebar and select Contacts, but I don't have all of the same options available to me here. I could also come up to the very top, select Google Apps, and then select Contacts. But the fastest way to get into Google Contacts from Gmail is to select the keys GC on your keyboard. By entering GC on your keyboard, it will immediately open up Google Contacts in a new tab. This is a quick and easy way for you to get exactly what you want whenever you're within Gmail. Tip number six, merge and fix. One of the strongest features of Google Contacts is its ability to look out for duplicates, so you can do your best to keep your contact list clean and accurate. Here in our menu, just below Contacts and Frequently Contacted, you'll see an area called Merge and Fix. And if there's a number beside it, it means that it's identified one or more that it may think is a duplicate. By selecting this option here, you can see that I have two different contacts here with the exact same name, and they also share one of the same email addresses. Now, I have the opportunity to review this first and decide whether it is, in fact, two separate people, and then I could select Dismiss, or I can see that, wait a minute, this is the same individual, but I want to keep the information. I'd like to combine these new email addresses along with this phone number. In that case, all I need to do is select Merge. And if you have multiple duplicates, you can always select Merge All here in the top right corner. Tip number seven, undo changes. A little known fact among Google Contacts users is that you can go back in time. So if you've made a number of changes, if you've given someone else access, or you just want to go back to the way things were, you can do so right here within Google Contacts. Up in our gear icon, if we select this, and then select Undo Changes, it's not just going to revert the last thing that you did. By selecting this option, we will get a new dialog where we can select a time frame. So maybe you just want to change the things you've done in the last 10 minutes. You can select this first option here, but you can extend it out to a few hours, to a week, to even a custom time frame within the last 30 days. Now note, contacts that have been deleted forever from trash cannot be recovered, but all other contacts and changes can by selecting this option. But what if undo changes is just not enough? And perhaps you're struggling to manage all of your clients and customers here within Google Contacts. Well, then Crumble CRM may be a better solution for you. Here I am within my Crumble Contacts, where I can quickly and easily search for any of my contacts, But beyond just seeing their contact information, I can get valuable insights into my relationship with my clients. On the right-hand side, I can see the deals associated with this individual, including where they are and the value of those deals. In addition, I can see valuable reports and information about my sales funnel, so I can be sure to reach out and connect with my clients when and where I need to. If you're looking for something more than just a contact list and need something simple and easy to use, you should check out Crumble CRM. To learn more, just go to crumble.com or click the link in the description down below. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.